Hey, what's going on YouTube? Jake here with Venture Visuals, and today I'm so stoked. I'm not just exaggerating here. I'm very fired up to be showing you guys how to use these matte transitions to add some sauce to your next visual, okay? So let's jump right into the timeline here, okay? We're in Adobe Premiere Pro today, but you can use these transitions in a variety of different editing software. And as I hit play here, you can get a quick preview of a lot of these transitions. So you might be confused. You're going, Jake, these don't look like transitions, okay? I'm not seeing any clips transitioning, right? Well, these are just the transitions themselves, and the way you create matte transitions is you use black and white shapes, okay? And then we're gonna track matte key those black and white shapes to our footage. It's gonna make a really nice transition. Now that might sound a little complicated. Bear with me here. We're gonna break it down. It's gonna get real easy, real simple. I love these transitions. They're so clean, very cinematic. So let's go ahead and put one of these transitions to work. Now I got some of my favorite transitions from my pack here on the right side. Now you can download this pack on VentureVisuals.com. I also have a free version of this pack you can download by just downloading the free pack on VentureVisuals.com. If you're interested, check that out in the link below. But on the right side of these matte transitions, we got some music video clips I've been shooting the past couple years. Now I thought these are some good clips to use because they're just kind of cinematic looking, pretty awesome looking clips in my opinion. I'm just gonna pick out one of these transitions that I think looks cool. This one's pretty awesome. I really do like this last one too. This one's the cinematic up down. It's one of my favorites. Just quick, subtle, clean transition. So what I'm gonna do is just drag that to where it lines up with the cut in between these two clips. I'm gonna drag my first clip up one layer. I'm gonna drag my second clip over underneath that. So now we have a stack that looks like this, okay? Next up we gotta do is just cut this top layer, right? This top clip. So now we have it lined up perfectly with the transition. You can see the edges are just lined up perfectly. So if I play it back from here, now that we got this stack looking nice, you can see it's just nothing. There's no transition happening yet. It's just black and white shapes into the next clip, right? So we gotta generate this transition. We gotta make it happen. So what we gotta do is we gotta come over here to our effects tab, and we're gonna type in track matte key. This effect is basically designed for matte transitions. So what we're gonna do is just drag that onto our video clip that's on top, and we're gonna change our matte to the layer that our matte is on. So you can see it's on video layer 3 right here. So we're gonna change it to that. Now, once I play this back, nothing's happening, okay? The transition isn't happening yet. So we gotta change our composite using from Matte Alpha to Matte Luma. And now we got that transition happening. So let's play it back and check out what this transition looks like in full motion, right? Boom, so sick, how sick is that? So clean, and when you put it to some music, man, I'm telling you, it's gonna be saucy. All right, so let's go ahead and take another one of these transitions and try it again on another one of these clips. This one's kind of trippy. This one's like some data moshing. Some of these other ones, I really am a fan of these, like, these crinkled up ones right here that just kind of look like it's just you're smashing paper in your hand or something. Those ones are really cool. But I think for this next one, let's just go ahead and try this. Let's try the mosh pit one. The mosh pit one is like very creative. It's one of those very unique ones that's included in the pack. So we got another clip of him here. He's in the gas station, and then we got another clip of him here on the roof. So once again, guys, we're just gonna drag this first clip up. We're gonna take our mosh pit transition, line it up with that clip on top. Gonna take our second clip underneath, and we're gonna cut that first clip on top, take our track matte key, drag it on there, change it from matte to video 3, and then matte alpha to matte luma. And let's go ahead and check out what this mosh pit transition looks like right here. You see that? So sick. So we got some video clips here I shot last winter. As you can see, pretty cinematic looking, so I figured these ones would be good to try out a cinematic transition on. So I really like this transition. I think it's pretty unique. It kind of just like bounces around the screen a little bit before opening up to the next clip. So we're just gonna try that one on this set of clips, okay? So I'm just gonna copy paste it over here. We're gonna do the same thing we've been doing. You already know. We're gonna drag that transition up, line it up with the cut, drag our second clip down underneath, cut that top clip, add our track matte key, our beloved track matte key on top of that, and we're gonna change it to video 3. Matte Luma. And as you can see, we already got the transition starting to happen. So let's go ahead and play it back. Check this one out, guys. I mean, I think this is gonna be really dope. Yes, sir. Yep, so that's awesome. I love that, the way that looks. Personally though, I think it might be a little bit slow. So what we can do is just take this transition, hit Command R, and we're gonna change it to like something around 130% speed. So you can see that shortens the transition up a little bit, right? So all we gotta do is drag our first clip back in. And now when I play it back, it'll be a little bit faster of a transition. So check this out. Boom. I enjoy using these transitions on music video edits, on commercial edits, on professional edits even. I have included a lot of just practical transitions in the pack itself, as well as some creative ones too for your more saucy visuals. So whatever it is that you guys are working on, you gotta give these Magic transitions a try. They will work in almost every video editing software out there. This is why I include the free pack on my website, is so that you can actually try these transitions completely for free before you buy them, just in case you think you might have some issues in your software, because I am explaining all of this in Adobe Premiere Pro, and occasionally I do get people that hit me up using Final Cut Pro, Sony Vegas. So if you're using any of these other video editing softwares, don't be afraid. You can still download the pack and try it out completely for free. And if you have any questions at all, you can reach out to me. I will answer your questions. I'm always looking at my comments. I'm always looking at people who DM me on Instagram. I'm very responsive. So if you have any issues with the packs at all, just let me know. I'm happy to help you guys work through it. So if you guys are stoked to be using these matte transitions in your own edits, hit that like button down below. And if any of you creatives out there are interested in becoming a part of a growing community full of other creatives where we all motivate and inspire each other and try to get better, hit that subscribe button down below, because we're coming at it hard this year with the tutorials, with the community building. I want everybody in this community to get better at their visuals and at their edits through this channel, and I want everybody to network with each other on this channel. If you're doing any of that, if you're posting videos, if you're posting vlogs, if you're posting music videos, comment below. I'm gonna check your channel out. And I really appreciate everybody tuning in today. I'm very excited for this week, so let's get after it. Until next time, guys, I'm Jake Venner. Peace out.